I'm a leader of Arunachal People's Alliance. We are joint leader of United People's Freedom Front. Especially recently, my leader and myself and our party members, we visit twice to Jaffna. Almost the world think the Jaffna is TNA is supporting Jaffna people, and they are developing and economic and education, health, everything. But once you go see the grassroots level, if you go and visit to the farmers and who are living, the poor people, actually they are very suffering a lot. For a day they don't have, for a, at least the day meal is very difficult. They don't have proper employment, no income, no proper economic plan. If you say completely how health side. No, we especially you don't have a good drinking water. All high minerals, including and the toxic. Water, everything toxic level is more. So when you drink this water, definitely you will get within short period kidney failure also. So you don't have drinking water, and especially I have to tell this the Tamil politician who was leading Jaffna district, they said always they are thinking resettlement is wrong, you have to withdraw the army from there. Actually army is helping lot. Army is helping to a lot to the Tamil people. That's why I can feel, you know, we went there in a public say the army is better. You know, they are the one giving some drinking water and for some economic plan, and politicians should do this, but they are not doing. These people only doing, they are visiting their houses, they are giving economic plan and education side, they are helping, issuing books, bicycles, like this, lot of what they need for their life, they are giving lot. And they are taking bowser water for drinking water. But whether they want to stop this source. When they withdraw all the armies from there, one side they are expecting something else, never it won't come terrorism, anything. Now terrorism made by all this government and others. Tamil party is making the terrorism now. They don't have proper meals, they don't have economic levels, no education, proper education, no housing at all, no jobs. So what they will do? They will think something else. So that who making? Already provincial council has given more than 800 million rupees. They didn't work last 3-4 years, no development at all. India government gave 50,000 houses. That also house already built, but they are not handover. Some houses are there, no water. Some houses are there, no toilet. Right? Some houses are no roads, no electricity. So how can they can live? How you can see the media sites, all the houses they built and just keep it. So what other things I especially have to tell? All people thinking Tamils having problem in Sri Lanka. I never accept that. I'm not agree with that. We don't have any problems. As a Tamil, I'm also a Tamil person, a leader. Everywhere we can live, no problem. Now you see, if we build a temple in Jaffna, they said picketing and all this thing, don't build. God Buddha also belong to Tamils and Sinhalese. We are celebrating Tamil Sinhala New Year. We are going same Kovil, Katrangama and Siripada, Munnacharam, Tamil and Hindu. Sinhala Hindu Avrudha. This is the thing, no? So, we are celebrating same. So, how can you say, don't put temple in Jaffna? Nagavihara Puram, long time it's there. That means Buddhism is connected to Tamils, Hindus also. All the gods are Hindus and Tamils are connected. So, when you build a Kovil in Kittangi, Sinhalese people never there against that. They are supporting, they are funding, they are helping. But when you go and put a temple in Jaffna, or north and east area, they said, you can't put a built up a Kovil there. What is the question? This is the thing. And when you come and reset law, register here in other areas, Sri Lanka and other areas, east, north and south or Colombo, anywhere, Buddhist people, they don't come and live here. You can be contest even the election. You can get your register votes and contest election. Once you're a single-age person go and register there, they make him problem. Resettlement is wrong. So these things are unreasonable things. If you say, here we are Sri Lanka, the central bank governor, you see, take for example, is Tamil. Opposition leader, Amruthalingam was Tamil, and now Sambandhan also Tamil. And Director General of Health Service, Dr. Jagannathan was there. I can tell. And who are the now present prime chief minister as Vikneswaran, he was the chief justice, governor, chief governors, chief justice, Sarvananda, right? Chief army commander, Rudra Rajasingam, right? And all these people, central bank governors, attorney generals, all these peoples appointed by Tamils. You can be a MP, you can be a prime minister if you like, if you contest and win, you can be a president also, that's no problem. But under Desavalang rules, you can't buy lands in Japna, but anybody Tamil people can buy, any Tamils can buy. So this is the thing. Yen daya, they have caste problem. They see Betiklo Tamils, Kalambu Tamils, upcountry Tamils, Indian Tamils, like this they are dividing. But here it's not like that. So what my point, what I feel is, you don't get any problem in Sri Lanka. We don't have any problem. We have enough rights. Everywhere, every people, every family having problem. That's a small problem. Even now, Tamil parties, they have problem now, dividing. They have to other Tamil parties, they must think about their people. After 30 years, they are suffering a lot. No proper health service. At least they have give some good drinking water. That's why I'm telling. So if you pulled a temple, this is not a main problem. Built up temple, removing temple, taking army from there. Army is giving support. Army make any mistake, they can fight file against case to them. They gave a jail sentence also, no? Right? And recently that one girl was raped by somebody, you know, some security officers also connected to, they punish them. Army make mistake, you are to them. But army do good thing, you are welcome that. Most of 90% they are doing good things. There are some issues maybe, but issue you can't counter, it's not a counter issues. Public side, 100%, the poor people who are living, Chunnagam, Japna, Point Pedro, everywhere visit, we have the record, what the people say, I can prove this, myself and my leader, we went, we have the record. They said, army is supporting us, sir. They are helping for our meals, everything, giving water. It's not an army duty. Army duties recover the other things. They have to do the defense side. But they are going and doing welfare activities for the Tamil people, not single-age people. So if they remove the army from there, what will happen? That also they won't get any benefit. Again, the terrorism can come due to this. Right? That I can feel. So we need, all should get together, live together. Single people should settle there also. Tamil people are living here. We are not asking, no, Vellavathayan and Kottayana people go in the single area, don't wait here, don't live here, go and live at Japna. Never they ask, no. Even Gol people, whether they ask, Matra people, they ask, no. They are supporting. So this is the thing. What my feeling is that we are making, politicians making problem due to that, all these corruptions coming. So that's all I can tell. We have to together. So single people would live there. You have to build temples there. You know, you have Christian churches everywhere there, no? Even plantation site, everywhere we take. Everywhere Christian churches are there. Even Japna you get. Never people won't tell anything, no? All gods, no? All religion. So you can build anywhere, Kovil, anywhere, temple, anywhere, Buddhist temple, anything. Like Christian church everywhere building, nobody is against that, no? So I'm telling the truth. It's not supporting anybody. I can see my eyewitness, I can see. So everywhere the people, they are suffering a lot. So due to that, what the politician, Tamil politician feeling, they are all undercut everything. They are talking something here, telling something there. Mainly this is only for politics, not helping people, poor people. They are economic. Never if they are going like that now, you see, after 4 years, this government came, still plantation sector people, they are suffering a lot, they have said, they promised they are giving salary increment. Now, kerosene oil, diesel, petrol, everything, price have gone up. So their living condition is very poor salary. Their living is very difficult, no way to eat even proper meals. So every government, even the utter waste, this after coming this government, a lot of people, the promises they didn't give that. So I have to tell the truth. This country, the Tamils don't have any problem. We are living peacefully, equal rights, everything is there. Politician making problem, Tamils are having problem. Thank you.